In the early hours of February 20th Eastern Standard Time, Apple unveiled its long-awaited entry-level model. Contrary to previous speculations of it being named the iPhone SE4, Apple has designated this device as the iPhone 16e. Similar to the iPhone 16 series, it is equipped with the A18 chip, though with a reduced GPU specification. Notably, Apple has removed the MagSafe magnetic feature from the iPhone 16e. Let's delve into how Apple has showcased its meticulous design choices. The iPhone 16e features a 6.1-inch 60Hz notch display with Face ID support, and is powered by the A18 processor. The thickness is 7.8 millimeters, and the weight is 167 grams. A standout aspect is the debut of Apple's self-developed C1 5G modem, likely paving the way for the iPhone 17 series. In recent years, the iPhone's signal has been criticized, so Apple began to develop its own baseband to solve the signal problem. The iPhone 16 is available only in black and white, offering fewer choices compared to the standard and Pro models. Due to its notch display design, the iPhone 16e does not support the dynamic island feature. The A18 processor in the iPhone 16e has a downgraded GPU with one less core. Additionally, it lacks the camera control button. It comes with a single rear camera, lacks a macro mode, and does not support spatial photos or videos. Perhaps the most significant change is in wireless charging capabilities. Unlike the iPhone 16, the iPhone 16e does not support MagSafe or Qi2 wireless charging, limiting it to 7.5-watt Qi charging. This move might benefit phone case manufacturers, as users would need magnetic cases to achieve similar wireless charging functionality. Pricing starts at $599 for the 128GB model, $699 for the 256GB version, and $899 for the 512GB variant. As an entry-level model, the storage options seem quite expensive. The iPhone 16e adopts a USB-C port and supports 20W wired charging. Its battery life has been improved compared to the iPhone 16. However, the iPhone 16e does not support Wi-Fi 7 and lacks the second-generation ultra-wideband feature. The iPhone 16e's omission of the MagSafe magnetic feature and limitation to 7.5-watt Qi wireless charging is indeed unexpected. Users wishing to enjoy the convenience of Apple's magnetic accessory ecosystem will need to invest in magnetic cases, presenting an opportunity for case manufacturers. Overall, when compared to the iPhone 16, the iPhone 16e's specifications and pricing may not offer significant value for money. Okay. That's all for today's video. Please drop a like, leave your comments, and subscribe to us. See you next time. Bye.